Alexa, good morning.
Good morning. Comic book icon Stan Lee was born on this day in 1922. Co-creator of the Marvel Universe, he used his great power with great responsibility, crafting complex characters that made superheroes seem more human. Today, I just have one word in his honor. Excelsior.
Twenty was definitely a special year. I will not jump into details because, I mean, we've all watched the news. Because at the end of the day, we didn't have anything else to do, so I think every single one of us was keeping track of everything that happened during this year. The list is quite long, from fires to World War III scares to a freaking pandemic. Yeah, this is going to be a 2020 recap, but different. Let's face it, this year has been a total shit show, and to be honest, I am shooting this video for the second time because the first one I shot got me in a really dark place, and after seeing the footage, I wasn't happy. And I thought to myself, if I do go into that dark place and just moan and bitch about 2020, at the end, I'm letting all of the negative circumstances win. I remember just saying that you shouldn't be afraid to fail, and this year has been filled with failures everywhere, and that you can always learn something from that and get some positive from that. Yes, I can rant for hours about all the stupid and selfish people that I've encountered throughout the year and all of the misfortune that we all had to face this year. And actually I did, but that goes in the dark archive. And so instead, in this video, I'm going to focus on the things that I'm grateful for, as well as the lessons I've learned from this year. There are a lot of things that people take for granted, and situations like the one that we had in 2020 definitely points out that the little things are what's important at the end of the day. And what I'm grateful for is that me, my family, and my friends are all healthy and alive, thank God, because not a lot of people had this luck during this year. And although there were some friends that got infected with the COVID, they managed to pull through and they're already healthy and recovered. Speaking about health, well, I'm also thankful for all the medical staff that has been working all over the world, insane shifts, because all of the emergency rooms are pretty much filled up all over the place and trying to save as many lives as possible. Definitely the situation has shown that there are a lot of problems with the health systems all over the world, doesn't matter in which country, and there is always room to improve. But all of those people kept on pushing, and a lot of doctors actually lost their lives because they also got infected. Even if they didn't get infected, they still had to work, and they are still working hard in order to provide good healthcare to as many people as possible. Speaking about people on the front lines, that's a term being used throughout this year, that medical staff is on the front line against Corona and so on. There were other events like fires, there were terror attacks, there were a lot of things, but we need to mention all of the essential workers. That goes for firemen, that goes for policemen, that goes for the people in your local grocery store or at your gas station that kept working throughout the entire year and that were vital for keeping the system actually working and providing basic services that we all need in order to survive. Also, another thing about all the people that are working such essential jobs is that something that I've noticed is that most of them do get minimum wages, and that's actually a lesson I've learned throughout this year, is that for example, in countries like Germany, where tipping is not popular, unlike in the US, for example, that I should definitely start tipping more people like this. And I actually do this since this year. I leave my change in the grocery shop if I pay cash. Same goes for the gas station. Whenever I order food or get something, I always tip as well. I'm also thankful for all of the scientists all over the world that were working in the background, because they didn't get a lot of attention throughout most of the year. And they were working hard in order to provide a vaccine. Of course, it's still not known, and the vaccine is not fully tested, but for the first time in human history, we managed to secure a vaccine so quickly, especially for something that's completely new to us. And that required definitely a shit ton of work. And kudos to all the scientists that were involved in that and are continuing to develop different types of medicine and vaccines in order to hopefully have a positive outcome from all of this crap in the near future. We all faced different types of setbacks throughout the years. Basically, most of our plans went down the drain. But I am thankful that although I didn't make progress in aspects where I wanted to make progress, I did make a significant amount of progress in other locations that I didn't expect. And I thought that I would never have time to do that. And that's another lesson I've learned. Although I think that 3 to 5 year plans are really, really a good thing to have, that doesn't mean they are set in stone. And sometimes the circumstances mean that you need to change, adapt, reprioritize your stuff. And if you do it properly and on time, you might actually still be on the right track at the end of the day or the year. I'm also thankful that in the midst of this shitstorm, there were still people that were thinking rationally, that there were still people thinking about others and trying to help. Like there were plenty of organizations, volunteers that help people in quarantine, bring them food or whatever. And there were also volunteers in the hospitals. At first, it might have seemed really dark, mainly because the media focuses on this and shows only the negative sides. And to be honest, it's a bit hard to find all of those news about the good people that are working hard, because, you know, let's face it, that doesn't get clicks as much as negative news. I had to dig deep to find as many as possible just to restore my faith in humanity, so to say. But definitely there were a lot of cases like that in all around the world. I'm also thankful for photography, because definitely doing photography helped me find the beauty in small details in some time of the year where things felt pretty dark. So I'm going to take this time here and just share with you some photos that I took over the year and during the summer, where a small chances of traveling just a little bit. Nobody from us was actually prepared for what happened this year. Not the politicians, not your regular Joe, not anybody. And the fact that we actually managed to pull through this year is astonishing. And I think if we focus more on the positive side of things and try to learn as much as possible from all the points where we failed throughout this year, we can handle whatever 2021 throws at us. I do expect it, at least in the beginning of the year, to be tough, like this year has been. But I think we can handle it, and by the end of next year, I think we will have a lot more positive things to celebrate. And on this point, I would like to wish all of you a happy new year, happy new 2021, best of luck throughout the new year. And as the end of this video, I would like to just take a moment in order to honor all of the lost lives throughout this year and just pay our respects